Hey Dad, how hot does this have to get?
310.
310 what?
310 degrees Fahrenheit.
Fahrenheit. Just wanted to make sure it wasn't Celsius or Kelvin. You know?
Who's Kelvin?
And this is the next batch right here?
Yep. Corn syrup, sugar, water, a little cream of tartar. And that's it.
That's it.
All ingredients you can pronounce.
I hope. And what do you call this contraption?
This is an antique chopper. Put the string of a rope of candy across and it chops it to little pieces. That's how you make all the little pieces.
So if this broke, how would you get another one? Can't you get another one?
I don't know.
See, it's in pretty good shape.
It actually is. It's just like, I don't know how old it is. It's really old though.
200 years?
Not that old.
Not as old as you?
No.
Wait, say that again for the camera, Mom.
I'm going to add the flavor in the kettle instead of on the table because orange is a weak flavor. I usually pour it on the table.
This doesn't look like a table.
It's very untable-like.
Some might even call it a kettle.
It's a pot called the kettle.
Kettle?
The kettle.
I like orange a lot. It's like one of my favorites, probably. Oh, look. Syracuse orange.
It's so not harsh.
Is that why you guys do orange? Because we're in Syracuse?
People hate it, but we make it anyways.
Just because.
Because of SU.
Uh-huh. Is this Dad's cup? The My Little Pony one?
Actually, yes, it is.
That was the only clean one I could find.
Uh-huh.
It's his favorite cup.
My favorite cup.
Sounds like your story's
his
changing.
His day doesn't go right if he doesn't use that cup.
Yeah. Lucky cup.
Mm-hmm.
What are you doing now? Is that like another droop test?
No, I'm just trying to get the candy off the paddle as much as I can before I take it out.
That looks like a pretty high-tech paddle, too.
Yep.
Is that the paddle holder over there?
Paddle holder, yep.
So okay. We'll call it a nail.
Yeah.
Okay. Are you ready?
Yesterday, I bought sugar, and I noticed it said non-GMO.
Yeah?
Yeah, that was good, right?
I guess it's healthy sugar.
They didn't have any with GMOs, so I got it anyway.
Yeah, I think GMO sugar is just sugar beet sugar, so it's probably sugar cane. That's probably what it was.
Okay.
Oh, he's got like a Bill Cosby sweater on.
I like it. It's colorful.
Yeah. Oh, I gotta sit down after all this hard work.
Yeah,
ugh.
Take the load off.
The thing about orange is it doesn't make you cry.
That's what we're doing next.
Peppermint?
Yes.
That's what I thought.
We're actually going to do a double batch of peppermint because we need the hard candy to smash up and put in peppermint bark.
Blob. It's coming close to me.
This is son of a blob.
Son of a blob! You talking about me or the blob?
The blob. I wouldn't call me a blob.
Yeah.
Or your popsicle. Chilling up now. I'm gonna go back to the middle because apparently it's pretty chilly there. It turns cold quickly. I'm gonna add the food coloring.
Hurry! So I know you're going to make like a whole video about how to order ribbon candy, but you want to tell people how this tastes exactly the same as ribbon candy, but it won't break as much?
I'd be happy to. It's the same recipe. Even on the table, we do the same stuff to it. It's just when we go over in front of the candy heater, what we do to it there that makes it hard candy or ribbon candy. We're just going to put this through a high-tech chopping machine.
Which you guys already saw.
Yes. That's how we're going to chop it up. So we're not going to use little tiny scissors. And so this will travel much better than ribbon candy. Ribbon candy, we promise, will be little shards of pretty colored sugar. But this, same recipe, much sturdier and more travelable.
Is that the technical term?
Shippable.
Travelable and shippable?
Yeah, they're like the same thing mostly. But if people really want pretty colored shards of sugar, this starts out his life as ribbon candy.
Instead of lumps of sugar?
Instead of what?
Instead of lumps of sugar?
Yes, this will be more uniform lumps of sugar.
Flavored sugar.
Right, and colored.
Mm-hmm. How's it doing on the droop test?
Not so good. It's droopier than we would
droopy.
Like.
Too droopy.
Too droopy.
Oh, you got some stuck to your glove?
No big. Happened before. Everybody came out okay. Mostly.
Hey, Dad. Who made that Hercules candy co-sign that Mom's head's in the way of?
Brad.
Brad did?
Brad.
He used to do woodworking.
Oh, really? Ooh. Is that paint or like, is it?
Oh, no, that's wood burned into it.
Oh, it's burned into it?
Yeah.
Wow. Pretty legit.
Now it's getting there,
oh,
Steve.
Yeah. Looking good.
Move it down here. Chills it right up. Or down, whatever. Whatever direction you want to go. It's less hot.
Well, look at that. Dad's got a big hand.
It's huge.
It's huge, Tom. Huge.
Who's Tom?
Tom. But Billy Fusillo, and what's the other guy's name?
Tom.
Just Tom?
Parks.
Oh, okay. I thought he just had like one name, like McLovin.
Like Madonna?
McLovin. Or I guess Madonna.
Cher?
Yeah.
I don't know any McLovin. Who is this McLovin person?
It'd be super bad. Oh. Come on, Mom.
Have I watched Superbad a lot?
Probably a couple times.
Was I awake for it?
Not gonna guarantee that. Do you just want to make it like a lighter color orange?
Yep.
Yeah.
Cool it down. Air add.
Bubbles.
Strike that. Reverse it. Add air.
So what's the high type unsticker look like?
It's new.
Candy only, what's that say?
Candy only.
Candy only. And then it says for candy only again. Just in case you didn't see it the first time.
Yeah.
Don't worry, it says it on both sides.
Yep.
Three times.
Hold on. Candy making only. Wow. If somebody uses it for anything but that.
Dead meat.
I don't know. More than that, they're just dumb and illiterate.
You
need
a bank.
A little stuck there.
Yeah, a little bit. There we go. This is a good shot. Orange candy next to SU.
Yeah, that's pretty good. What on earth?
What was that?
An earthquake?
A dustpan shifted.
Wasn't there Oompa Loompas stuck in there?
Yes. No Oompa Loompas were harmed in the making of this candy.
Not yet. So where can you get a candy cane hook like this? Or just a candy hook, I should say.
I don't think they're made. They're just like passed down from generation to generation, but I don't know where they came from originally. I think they were given out at the beginning of time.
Yeah. Just always existed.
Yep.
You just have to find them.
I think these are like the same as the old meat packing companies. I don't know if they still have them.
Probably also handed down by generation to generation.
You hit that?
Oh, yep.
One more.
Okay, I guess I can take it off. Yeah, nice orange.
Thank
you. Got that cool artsy look. Oh, I'm down really low. Oh, that's in focus. Now I gotta get that in focus. Oh, look how artsy I am.
There's just so many ways to be artsy, aren't there?
Yeah. Especially with this autofocus. Oh, no, I focused on the wrong thing. Shit. Well.
There's no going back.
Yeah, no going back now.
I'm gonna gloss and make it nice and shiny.
Nice candy. Pretty candy. Aw, candy, I love you.
I love it, and I pat it. I crush it! What are the exact words, Dad? You would know.
No, I never saw it.
Don't know what you're talking about.
Dad, you pretend to be Chris Farley for a second. What does he say?
I hog it, I rub it, and then I squeeze it back! That's where it all goes wrong.
Then she gets some chicken wings, right?
Yeah. And she says, boy, you're sick.
You're sick. He did have that head wound. He wasn't himself.
Yeah, I feel like he had a lot of head wounds in that movie.
Funny movie.
If you like that.
Oh, this is the high-tech candy cutterizer. How long does it take to learn how to use this contraption?
Up to 30 seconds.
That long, huh?
Yeah.
Many years.
Oh no, you left one behind!
There's no going back.
Yeah. Well, guess you gotta start this whole batch over again.
Throw it out.
Gotta get a lot of different angles for everyone on this, too. Oh, these are the other flavors you guys made. What have you guys made so far?
Pink.
I thought you were just gonna say pink flavor.
Pink
flavor. Pink and green.
Pink and green flavor. And then the green. The lime green one. Is it lime? No, it is not. It is anise. And then the bluish green one. That is clove. Mm. We want it to be bluer, but it's not.
That pink one, what? Is that winter green, Nelly said?
Yep.
Because the winter green berries are pink?
Apparently.
It's just a traditional color for some reason.
Pepto-Bismol.
Pepto-Bismol flavored?
That's winter green-ish.
Yeah. Surprised it's not a better seller. Pepto-Bismol flavored.
I know. Gum. Bubble gum. That's pink.
Yeah.
But not winter green.
Do all pink things taste the same?
Mostly.
Tastes like pink. Pink the singer?
Pink is my favorite color.
Finish it, Steve.
I don't know.
Don't please us.
The words.
Is that a song?
It's like Steven Tyler is right here. You know, the Aerosmith.
The Aerosmith. These are way smaller than the candy cane ribbon cane batch, or candy cane and ribbon cane batches, ribbon candy batches.
Say that again.
What?
I can't. It was too hard the first time.
These are 9-pound batches, and ribbon candy, those can be anywhere from 15 to 18.
These are just small batches because
not huge
hard
sellers.
Candies don't sell as much as you used to anymore.
But if you try to discontinue it, people will freak out.
Yeah.
That's how it works.
You have to have kind of a happy medium. So this is only going to make about 63 pounds.
For the whole day, you mean?
Yep.
So you have anise, wintergreen, orange, and what was the other one?
Clove.
And then what else are you guys doing today?
We will do peppermint, I think cinnamon, although it could be lemon. I'll have to look at the label. And molasses.
And how do you guys do molasses?
We use real molasses.
Oh, when you guys made the candy canes, didn't you use all the other extra pieces or something?
Yeah, anything extra, any pieces, you just throw it in there because the molasses covers it.
Just adds more volume?
Yeah, it does add more volume.
That's the secret.
Mm-hmm. More, it makes it more voluminous.
More gooder even?
Especially more gooder.
Is there a certain technique to picking up the metal and moving it and putting it back?
More than you'd think. You have to give it a certain flick of your wrist so that it busts it off and it lands.
Alright, I think you guys get the picture. This is pretty much all I do until they run out of candy.
Rinse and repeat. So you want to order ribbon candy to be shipped, even though you've been told it's a bad idea.
Something about sending ribbon candy and it's going to be broken. Yeah, we wrap it in bubble wrap.
Okay, yeah, I'll wrap it in bubble wrap.
What about packing peanuts? Can you do that?
That will also be in packing peanuts, yes.